So it's been 3 years since I reviewed the Phantasm movies. At the end of my last review, I talked about how a fifth and final chapter in the franchise was on its way. And it's finally here. Technically, it came out in 2016, but I've only just gotten my hands on it and given it a watch. And right off the bat, I will say that this is the worst movie in the entire series. I was quite disappointed by this new movie, which is a shame because I think people were probably hoping that I'd praise this film and consider it to be among the best in the series. But I just can't do that for many, many reasons. The film travels back and forth between two possible realities, never saying which one is a dream and which one is the actual reality of the story. And to be fair, this is not even out of the ordinary for the series and something that I could accept if it's actually done well. However, the way they do it is incredibly frustrating. The film is all about Reggie. We see him waking up in the desert after the events of the previous movie, still on the trail for the tall man and trying to find Mike also. There is a section that lasts maybe about 15 minutes that feels like what you'd expect from a Phantasm sequel. We see Reggie trying to get into a woman's pants and then said woman being killed by the tall man. This section is honestly one of the highlights of the movie for me, which is pretty terrible considering it's not even very good at all. But it recaptures the humor of the second and third movies perfectly and is quite entertaining. After this, the film completely loses it. The film goes back and forth between this and also Reggie in a psychiatric hospital. Here he's been told that he's suffering from dementia and that the events of the movie and previous movies is all in his head. However, Mike, who looks very much like Geddy Lee in this film, comes in later and says that he had a dream about everything that he's talking about. This makes it really hard to actually decide for what's going on. In the main story of the film, the tall man has taken over the world, creating a post-apocalyptic wasteland. This idea is definitely interesting and leads to some moments that are tense and exciting. However, the thing that really ruins these scenes is the effects. The first movie had a very small budget, so it inevitably had pretty terrible effects a lot of the time. But there were also some very creative and well done effects also. They worked to the limit of their budget and it really shows. And even when it doesn't, it's weirdly quirky and charming. Here, however, the effects are just horrendous. There is an over-reliance on CGI, and the CGI is honestly some of the worst I think I've seen in recent years. Like, this is below even sci-fi original movie standards. I've seen better effects to come out of a Sharknado movie. Every single CGI shot is ugly and amateurish, and it completely takes me out of the film. And speaking of ugly and amateurish, this is one of the worst shot horror movies I think I've ever seen. This film is full of awkward camera angles, terrible framing, and the whole thing has a very cheap look to it. I've honestly seen YouTube movies that were better shot than this. This film is the first movie in the franchise to not be directed by Don Coscarelli, and God does it show. Don Coscarelli is an incredibly talented film director. He knows how to shoot a film well, how to direct actors, and how to make bad effects actually work and not be incredibly distracting. However, the new director here doesn't do any of these things. And I'm not trying to personally attack the director of the film at all. This is his first movie and first time creating something live action after a long career in making cartoons. But I feel like the rest of the production crew could have helped him create something that wasn't so poorly made. The story of the film is incredibly messy and at times almost impossible to understand. It feels like a lot of ideas were just kind of strung together without anything linking it together. Tons of questions are left completely untouched and more are asked also. Something I liked about the first movie was how it didn't answer questions and left things very open to interpretation, which created something very mysterious and eerie. But here, the questions that are left unanswered are questions that are important to the plot. Questions like what happened after the events of the previous movie. The last film ended on a huge cliffhanger, and here they just pretend like it didn't even happen. They just move on and don't even mention it. They talk about how the tall man exploded, but then they don't talk about how Reggie went into the other dimension at all. He went into the other dimension, but how did he get back? We never find it out. It just never happened, apparently. The film also never really has a resolution. It just kinda ends. This is a huge issue, considering that this movie is supposed to be the final film in the series. So I was hoping for a big, epic closer that gave the story an end. ending. But it doesn't. A bunch of stuff happens and then it just kind of ends. The story gets no conclusion at all. And that really left me with a sour taste in my mouth. I finished this movie just confused as to what the point of the film was. There is not a single thing that happens in this movie that was relevant to the story of this series whatsoever. And if I waited 18 years for this movie to come out, I'd be incredibly angry because this film doesn't need to exist. It isn't exactly entertaining. It looks like a terrible student film. It has almost no story. It makes no sense and it has no conclusion. The only thing that keeps it somewhat enjoyable is the performances from Angus Scrimm and Reggie Bannister. They both do a great job in this movie. Sadly, Angus Scrimm passed away a few months before the release of this film, but luckily his performance was very, very good, so I'm glad that he ended his career putting in everything he possibly could. Reggie and Angus's performances are really the only good things about this movie. The rest of it is an incredibly disappointing, terribly made mess. If you're a big fan of the series, then I definitely recommend watching this one. It's possible that hardcore fans will find some enjoyment out of the movie that I personally couldn't, but honestly, I can't help but feel really let down here. I wanted to love it, but it was impossible for me to do that. In fact, a lot of the time it was near impossible for me to even enjoy the movie at all. So, it sucks to say this, but I give Phantasm 5 Ravager a 2 out of 10. So, thanks for watching my Phantasm 5 review. I want to thank everyone who requested this. I've actually been getting quite a few requests over the last few months since the film came out on DVD. And I'm glad that there's people out there that actually had interest in seeing me talk about this film. I promise I'm going to start some more horror movie series reviews later on in the year. Hopefully I'm going to have one out by the end of July. I can't promise that 100%, but I'm gonna try my hardest. So hopefully that'll be out soon, and hopefully you guys will check it out and enjoy it. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.